What do you got? What do you got? I think I actually mulligan this hand. On the draw, no play until turn 3 Rexage. Turn 3 Witness is also not that good. And, yeah. Gotta keep this on 6. You can take one value mulligan. You probably can't take two. Alright, let's see if I can hit a Mana Accelerant of any kind. Any kind of Mana Accelerant. Alright, this hand becomes much more palatable. Metamorphing the Geist doesn't kill the Geist, unfortunately. I could metamorph the... The thing is, I can metamorph the Exarch, but I can only tap the Exarch. I can't tap the Geist. I actually don't think there's a way to get out of that with Metamorph there. Okay, for a second I thought my opponent was going to kill my Elf. It's like, does every single opponent need to kill an Elf? Ooh, alright. I drew a card to play. So now this hand is turning very good, having a one drop as it turns out. I just get to play turn 4 Foff into turn 5 Primal or Thragtusk. You know, I thought it was a little weird at first when you play against cards you have, like Oath of Nissa, because of the draft leagues, but I'd rather just get to play 5 matches in the time that it would take me to play 2. Chandra, Fire of Kaladesh? That is not the card I expected to see. I mean, there's no one card I expected to see, I guess, but that certainly is not... Not it. I'm just gonna attack and leave mana up and hope my opponent doesn't attack me. Ping attack with Chandra. And also, I don't really care too much if Chandra minus doesn't actually kill. Like, Finks comes back and then kills Chandra. So. Opponent looks pretty solidly red green, but they have good fixing, so. It makes sense. No plays. Nothing. 5 mana. Alright. Let us cast Foff and see what my opponent does. Witness, Edric, Tribelder, 2 lands. Pretty decent, pretty decent. So, what am I taking here? Lands versus spells. Edric and... If I knew my top card was a land, I would certainly take the top pile because there's better cards, but if I've got 3 5 drops in hand, I feel like it's kind of irresponsible not to take a land here. Also, if I took the other pile and they like killed Fyndhorn Elves, that would be real bad for me. And they might kill Fyndhorn Elves end of turn still. They did not. I'm just going to... Actually, let's not... Let's go... I'm at 22. I have millions. So I'm going to put Forest on top of my opponent's deck and search for a creature. This kills one of their land. It actually sets them back 2 lands because it kills the Fertile Ground and makes them miss a land drop. And then I get to go get another creature, which I don't really need, but I don't really need 7 life either. So I think this is pretty good here. I have so many 5 drops. I got pinged, huh? I don't even really want almost any of these 5. Like, it's just a straight TRG. I'm never going to cast all the cards in my hand. So what can make the biggest difference here? Metamorph? Probably Metamorph. Definitely not Battle Ball. Could take Wolfear. I'm just going to take Metamorph. Metamorph seems like it covers the most bases. Maybe my opponent plays something that I care about. Opponent can shuffle away a forest if they want with Wither Foothills, but this set them back a lot in terms of... what they're doing. Actually, yeah, I'm just going to keep attacking here. I'm not sure what my opponent's up to with this Chandra, but I think I'm doing okay here. Alright, my opponent did not sack Wooded Foothills. They want to draw Forest. If they have a red card, they can flip Chandra, but I think that's okay. Then I can go, if I want, I can go Nissa, send in something. I guess if my opponent goes Bolt Your Elf, I can't Nissa an attack, which is unfortunate. But I still get to go like Thragtusk attack. Let's see what they've got. I assume they've got a red spell here. The thing is about gaining 7 is that I also have Thrag Tusk in hand, and Metamorph gains me life off Thrag Tusk, because I think that's a good chance I Metamorph the Tusk. Which is pretty good against red-green. Especially this might be an... I actually can't tell what my opponent's trying to do. Like, Oath of Nissa and Fertile Ground imply green ramp, and then Chandra and Incinerate imply aggressive stuff. Squirrel loot. Thank you, thank you. Some bits. At no point will I change my behavior based on a Tumblr post, because I don't think I ever read anything on Tumblr. No, I just say... I know it's Chandra. I just say Chandra sometimes because I like to. Opponent Incinerated, then Chandra the Sphinx. Alright, I think it's Nissa time. Nissa, no Jedi. Actually, I'd rather... Oh, it's become tapped. Every time I attack with City of Brass... Alright, I already played it. It doesn't actually give haste either. Alright, let's just make... I think an island is actually my least valuable land. Forest... Nissa untapping forest means... I do want to keep her. Sorry, Roaring Flame. Humph. Good. Now we're winning. By a lot. Alright. Untap some forests. Thragarino. I do like burrito money. Paying 3 life, paying so much life for this Phyrexian Metamorph. That's okay. So many tusks. Shoomp. And a smash. I think I'm in good shape here. I would say that. So, my opponent's gonna need something pretty good. Alright, do I want Rex Sage against... I saw Fertile Ground, but red-green's not usually rich in targets. I might play Garruk, because that's just good mid-range matchups. Beast Within, exclude Serac. Eh, let's just go Garruk, I think. They're the max number of Oath of Nissas in this... in this particular matchup, I think. Is double Thrag Tusk even as good as a Karn? On that board, I believe so, yes. But it depends on what's going on in general, I would say. Is Searing Spear even in the cube? Can you have any spears? There's Spear of Heliod. I guess technically Spear of Heliod could take down Thrag Tusk, then take down the beast. Alright, win this match, win the next match, be 2-1, respectable. I have no cube trophies, and I've done 5 drafts. To be fair, I did go a little bit off the reservation on some of the drafts, but what can you do? Oh, Incendiary Flow? Yeah, but that I'm talking about literal Searing Spear. Reprint Karn. Well, that's a big ask. Karn, first of all, has some story implications, and second of all, it is a pretty powerful card. I don't know. Matt, so you get someone to permit you, and you can post a link, as it turns out. All right. What do we got here? Well, getting twin comboed all 3 rounds would be unfortunate, but what can you do? Ooh. Oh, yeah. This hand is great. All the new Phyrexia goodness. I get to play turn 1 Tree Speaker, turn 2 Tree Speaker, Pilgrim, Oath of Nissa. Metamorph on Tree Speaker is not actually that effective because you have to re-level it up, but in general, I think this hand is fantastico. I don't know what that means, Venter giving his spark to Karn. Bring out. Alright, opponent mulligan to 6, unfortunate for them. Mulligan to 5? This could be a route. This could be a route. Alright. Let's play turn 1 Tree Speaker. Wow, we get to have turn 3 Garrick Relentless. Alright. If my opponent has Bolt here, then yeah, that's unfortunate. Whoop, never mind. Let's just take Devoted Druid. Don't think I need Forest here. And Abyssinth Pilgrim. Next turn, have... This is a turn 4 Karn, by the way. If my opponent plays a small creature and I go Garrick your creature, Devoted Druid, next turn Karn. Ugh. Thank you, Nas TV. Appreciate it. Oh, they have Chain Lightning. Well, better late than never, I guess. I could Devoted Druid. I can't Witness back and play Tree Speaker. I only have 2 green. Bum, bum, bum. I could just Garrick and make a creature. Yeah, that kind of strikes me. If I knew I was drawing a land, I guess I would be more inclined to play Devoted Druid, but Garrick make a wolf seems pretty good. Actually, hold on. Oh, no. Even with Mana Confluence, you can't combine Oath of Nissa and City of Brass to not take... or Mana Confluence to not take damage off casting Garrick. Nissa. No Jedi. Alright, so... get a Forest, and then Garrick eats Nissa. I'm in for that exchange. If my opponent has Lightning Bolt, I mean, that's cool, but... Humph. I don't need to copy this. I drew a land already, so let's go... Devoted Druid. I could Witness. I don't even want to cast Witness. Let's just play Devoted Druid, and then... Now we're just in great shape, I think. Bum, bum, bum. I can combine City of Brass and Oath of Nissa in order to spend any color mana as if it were any color mana. That is pretty smart here. Oblivion Stone. I would be worried about that. But. I guess if my opponent had a way to kill Devoted Druid, that would be unfortunate there. Yunk. Yeah. Alright, I've got 2 Planeswalkers out, my opponent has none. They don't have any non-land permanents in play, in fact. And let's just make a Death Touch Wolf and attack for 2. Wolf, and... I guess I can't F8 because Devoted Druid could technically activate itself. Well, that's alright. Oh, come on. Please. Ah, Karn! Getting incinerated. My opponent could have incinerated Devoted Druid to prevent Karn from coming down. But what can you do? Bash my opponent down to 15. Okay. This is a way back. Can kill my Garrick and like a wolf token. No current plans to stream Vintage. Once Kaladesh comes out, if it impacts Vintage, I might be interested, but I played so much of the, like, kind of current Vintage that, I don't know, I'm not really feeling it these days. So what's my best opponent's best thing to kill? They could, if they want to, they could just kill my 2 mana dorks and my wolf, or one of the mana dorks and the wolf. Opponent has no cards in hand, though. I guess that's pretty relevant. Since if they leave the mana creatures alive, I can go like Witness back Karn, Metamorph, deal 3 to you, and then have an Inferno Titan. Alright, so they're killing Abyssinth Pilgrim and presumably Garrick as well. Mm-hmm. 5 mana. could just metamorph here. Yeah, that's probably best. There's no real point in getting back anything, because my opponent could just kill Devoted Druid and the wolf. Otherwise, alright. Titan you for three. Say Titan you for three. Alright. Pass the turn. So now my opponent can kill my Devoted Druid and my Death Touch Wolf. And I guess I probably am just best off just trading Inferno Titans, even though I'm losing a bunch of creatures. Yeah, Inferno Titan did some work this game. My hand is very good. If I take it, I take 10 down to 7, and then I can attack my opponent for 11, 12. Technically 12, but if they have a creature... I'm no coward. Sliver and Onion. 3, 9, 3, 7. Alright, they have a creature. It's a Worm Coil Engine? What? Okay, that did not turn out the way I had hoped. Let's play a Kitchen Finx and pass the turn. Worm Coil Engine? Why me? Oh, man. Alright, well... I did not think that was showing up next. Alright. Let's see what happens now, huh? Okay, Finks comes back. Well, I've got to kill the Inferno Titan now, I think. And let's take 6. This game actually looked stone unlosable. And yeah, I mean, if my opponent has another spell here, I might lose. If they don't have another spell, I think I could be in okay shape. Handgun Garrison? Okay, sure. That I think I can live with. Because now I can go Witness back Metamorph, and then that will become a Worm Coil. Alright, pass the turn. I think I'm just... I can kill that, I can trade those two for that, and I can block that, and I can go to 1, and then I play Metamorph on Worm Coil. Sure. Can't even tap City of Brass now. Alright, what am I going to draw? They probably drew something here, I would imagine. No. Interesting. Okay. One coil. Okay. Okay, let's dodge on Oath of Nyssa. I mean, I've got a lot of things going on. I feel like I'm up enough cards that I might be able to pull back here, despite being... Oh, they got a Stomping Ground? Yeah, that works for me. Okay. So if they trade Worm Coils, I get my City of Brass back. I think that worked. I think I'm happy. But if they don't attack, I guess I can just get to attack anyway. This has been an interesting game. I thought I couldn't win. Or rather, I thought I couldn't lose, and now I end up in a spot where I'm like clawing back from very far behind. But I think I'm actually advantaged. I'm assuming the card in my opponent's hand is just nothing, because I do Oath of Nyssa this turn. So I can cast Primal if I attack with Worm Coil. Actually, that seems pretty good. So what I want to do now is attack with a Worm Coil Engine. I put a trades or they don't. And either's fine with me because I gain my 6. And then I get to go Primal Command. I'm at 7. Put Stomping Ground back on top. Go to 6. Search for... I don't even know what my best creature is, like a Battle Sphere or something? Thragtusk isn't bad. Actually, it could be Rampaging Baloths. Yeah, I'm actually thinking Baloths is going to be great here. And then play a tapped Breeding Pool. Now my opponent's going to skip their turn. And then... Because again, I'm assuming whatever they do the turn before Oath of Nissa didn't do anything. So, you know, I can assume it's just a land. And then... next turn I can go Baloths, start making tokens every turn. If I draw a land, I'd probably just go Baloths land. And then next turn I can go Oracle and try to play multiple lands. The problem with soulballing the lifelink token is that once my opponent trades the Death Touch token for it, I end up like not super far ahead. I guess I could attack with the lifelinker. They did reveal it though, it was Stomping Ground. Oof. That's gross. Alright. Oracle of Mooly Dooly. Play a land, get a 4-4. Yeah, I would like to use the ability. Play a land, get a 4-4. Now I'm actually going to attack with the Lifelinker and the Death Toucher. And actually the Beast. Yeah. And I can cast Foff now. Or I can just draw Nissa, but I think I'd rather cast Foff. Alright, so I gain some life. Now I'm really far ahead. Now I think I probably can't lose here. I'm going to shuffle away the Nissa, get a 4-4, because I'm going to do that anyway. Oh yeah, Thragtusk, I like it. Alright. Just going to take Thragtusk, I don't care about the rest, though. Nykthos actually not that insane here. Yeah, you can start at Thragtusk or no, and I'll still take Thragtusk. Land. Thragtusk. Yeah, the swings in this game have been something. Boom, boom, boom. Could attack with the wolf, but yeah. Or the Baloth, I think that's probably pretty bad. Basically, if I attack with Wolf, it lets my opponent just eat a Wolf and gain 3 with the Lifelink Worm, trade a Death Touch Worm for, like, one of those things. And then... Come on, just trade the Worm Coils off. Oh, it would have been so cute if you just completely traded off. Oh, Oliver, we are doing it. I think this game's now pretty much over. This game wasn't a can't-lose situation, then a can't-win situation, so this is kind of nice. Blood Braid? What are you hitting? Explore. All right, there we are. Bam. 1-1.